Hello and welcome back. The last few videos for creating the navbar showed explicit ways to manipulate the design and development. In today's video, we will explore Droip in a different way, where we can develop with ease and less time. So without further ado, let's dive right into it. After our hero section, we have a bunch of other sections. We will show how to reuse our components and how easily we can structure the rest of the page. So first things first, let's take a section and set a container. We will reset the max width to none for our container. As we added styles, Droip automatically creates a new subclass. Let's add another subclass for padding, and the creation of this new subclass will be very handy in the next steps. Now let's take two divs, one for the title part and the other one for the project displays. For the title, we will have some words here and a button. Taking a heading element, eliminate the default margins, change the typography, cyan, size 100, bold and capitalize. Copy this heading and paste it again. And we will simply copy the button from above. And we are almost done. As both the headings have the same class, thus changing styles will affect both of them. To give the second heading a gap here, let's just duplicate the class, and in that way, the class will hold its previous styles, and at the same time having a new name, it will accept new changes without affecting the previous class. So advanced typography and text indent to 150 pixels. And there we have it. Now let's position the content of the title div in the middle. Flex row, justify space around, and align flex end. Let's duplicate the class for a button and give a margin of 15 pixels. And as smooth as that. One thing to notice is we are constantly having this same typography for headings throughout the design. Let's make the process easier, making a master class and then change based on needs. So next, we will try to structure the project list, giving the project div a display grid, and it would have two rows and three columns. Then we would like the fourth block to be merged and act as an area. And let's just do that. Okay, so the basic layout is assigned. Now let's just build a structure, a div display and another div within named as project. So inside the project, we will have a div text content and image. And also, let's upload a photo from the media manager and fast forward, update the texts. Now let's give display a top bottom padding of 40 pixels and a structure of flex center center. And also add border in four sides. Making copy of the display four more times and then make this fourth block to hold the area one like that. Fast forward, let's update the images. And yep, let's just give this whole grid a top and bottom border of 1 pixels, and it's that easy. So far, we tried applying the grid layout, and in the next section, we will try to use flex for structuring. The section 2 will have a container holding two SVGs on the edges, and the middle portion will have the text elements. Assign the base subclass and another new subclass to make the container flex row and center center. Let's fast forward, copy the SVG codes for planet and the TV, and then paste on the left and right side accordingly. For the middle part, let's make two partition with two divs and make them flex column center center. Add heading element and set the master class for heading that we created earlier. And then duplicate the class to make new changes in the font size and centering. For the lower part, let's take a heading, assign the master class again and duplicate, change sizes and add 8 pixels of padding and border radius overall. Copy heading element two more times and give the lower a flex row center center. Now give first heading a class hue1 and set the color. Next, add lowercase for the second heading and hue2 for the third heading and set the color as well. Lastly, give the planet div 100 pixels of margin. and we are done to roll. So less work to design, right? Well, you might find better strategies to minimize steps while exploring with Droip. In the next section, we will try to combine flex and grid together to structure the layout. Let's see how we can do that. Taking a section and then a container, container base class assigned and a new subclass for padding and the background color. Also, let's structure flex column center with a row gap of 88 pixels. Let's split the contents in two parts, up and down. Copy the title from the upper section and paste under this up div here and make it flex center. For the down, let's do two partition, left and right, and then give the div down a flex row center and column gap of 90 pixels. Set the right part with an image from the media manager, and for the left, let's set the structure to grid with 100-100 grid gaps. Then let's take a div element for the grid, set a heading and a paragraph, copy three more times and we are all set. So like this way, we can effortlessly create and design our layouts. For the team member section, we will use the concept of dynamic content, and the whole thing is explained in the playlist added in the description of this video. And lastly, for the footer, we will simply try using the Figma to Droip. Let's go to Figma, plugins, add Figma to Droip, select your section and generate, make a copy, and then fast forward paste it in the Droip canvas. And it's that easy. And with that, we are wrapping up this playlist. The playlist included multiple ways of designing flexibility in Droip. And with more exploration, you can get the most spectacular development experience. Thank you and stay tuned for some more exciting concepts ahead.